We'd like to thank each one of you for coming today and taking this opportunity to learn a little bit about the patient move for LaPorte Hospital. You can see the absolutely gorgeous facility that we will be occupying on the 24th of October. We participated along with InHealth and developed this video to give everyone a high-level view of what the patient move should look like. You can see the will be staged early that morning. The EMS providers will of course have open access into our facility. Along the path of travel, both in and out of the facility, you can notice the orange footprints. So there are five different paths of travel. The ICU path of travel happens to be orange footprints. You will each be given a crosswalk that will help you identify the path that you should travel. Also, we'll have four different points of checkpoints, and we'll review those as we go along. So EMS comes into the room regardless of which unit it is. If the patient is an ICU patient and they are intubated, an anesthesiologist or a CRNA will be riding along with that EMS unit. Report is given at the bedside. The patient, of course, is switched over to the transport ventilator and transferred to the EMS stretcher, and I know you're very comfortable with that process. Our goal overall is to mitigate risk for the patient and provide a consistent and efficient organized process for relocating our patients. After the bedside shift report is done and the patient is packaged, the transport, of course, begins. At the point of egress off of the patient care unit, there will be an RN who will check the patient. She'll be doing the identifiers to make sure that it's the correct patient. She'll do a quick review and oversight of the patient to make sure that they don't have a change in condition and that they are cleared for transport. Just as a FYI for each of you, our medical staff here at LaPorte Hospital will be rounding on each one of the patients the morning of the move. So by 5 a.m., each patient will have had a provider round on them. You'll notice that the elevators are clearly labeled. We will have an elevator operator on each elevator. They will park on whichever floor they need to be on to either take the patient down to the point of egress or to pick the patient up. Again, please note the orange pass of travel. Each of the patients will also have a label on their left upper chest. That label will indicate the destination room number. Not surprisingly, each of those labels are also color coordinated with the patient care unit. You noticed at the point of egress, a nurse checked the patient again. So that would be our egress leader. At each point of exit, we have three different places that patients will exit from the origin facility. Our patient move does begin at 6 a.m. We ask that you be staged at origin in the staging area in the front parking lot at 5 a.m. We will be utilizing the incident command structure. Our commander will verify that each area is fully staffed and operational and ready to transport patients. Origin is ready to send patients, and destination is staffed and ready to receive patients. We anticipate the commander calling overhead by paging. The operator will page that the patient move is commencing. As you can see, it's a very short travel from origin to destination. One of the things we want to emphasize is that we're not in a rush. Do whatever it takes to provide a safe, efficient transport of the patients. Because ICU is going up what we call elevator number 5, they're going around to the back of the destination building and into an area over by elevator 5. We will have a security officer stationed at each point of egress. For the purpose of the move, we are restricting visitors. We always say common sense always prevails. As you can see, this elevator is located very close to that point of ingress. The patient was checked by an ingress leader, and this elevator actually goes directly in to the patient care unit. Again, as the patient comes onto the unit, the nurse is verifying the patient's location. Once the patient is traveling down the hall, we have a registration clerk. At that point, that registration clerk will change the patient's room number from the room they were at origin to the room they're going into at destination. The patient who is ventilated will have a ventilator already set up at destination, and they will be switched over. We will have a respiratory therapist on hand to transfer them from the transport ventilator to the regular ICU ventilator. Bedside shift report should be given from the EMS provider to the nurse. When EMS transports the patient, they will not have sheets on their stretcher. They will use the sheets that were underneath the patient at the origin facility. They will transfer them over in the destination bed, and their cot then will be sprayed down, disinfected. And then when they get to origin, it's a repeat of redressing the stretcher with the linen that is on the patient's bed. Our COVID patients will go to the end of the move. They will be moved last, and we will have dedicated EMS units to do that transport. The COVID unit path of travel, as you can see on this, is in yellow. They exit at this facility at origin out of the gathering, and then they go to the east and then north and over. Each EMS unit has a different path of travel. Our goal is to confirm that if someone breaks down, they are able to continue the patient move without blocking anyone else. So we'll review now the travel maps as well as the crosswalks so that you'll have an idea of what the actual patient move looks like. In addition to the EMS units that will be transporting our patients on patient move day, we have a moving company, and they will be relocating existing equipment. Now, starting on October the 5th, much of the existing equipment and departments have already been relocated to the destination facility, although obviously no patients have been. There are different paths of travel for the equipment trucks. Those are indicated by brown on the map that you have in front of you. And then we have a hot truck. And the hot truck is a truck that is dedicated to items that we only have one of. And while I will tell you there are not a lot of those items, there are a few of them. The hot truck has a dedicated path of travel. If the item is coming from surgery, it will be placed on the hot truck by itself. It'll be transported from origin to destination. It'll be immediately offloaded and placed into the surgical department that it came from. So the hot truck doesn't get a lot of other items packaged on that truck. The other thing that we have done and will have done by the time every EMS unit arrives on Saturday is on Monday before the move at 9:45 each day, our case management team is giving us a state of the hospital. Total census, number of patients by individual units, number of vented patients, BiPAP, CPAP, and COVID positive patients. Any patients that are being held in the emergency department awaiting transport to other facilities, and also any morgue patients. Each day we'll get a feel for how our census is trending, including our COVID census. We'll do that each day, and then on Friday, the case managers will begin communicating to our patients, because if they're there on Friday, we probably have a good idea that they're going to be a part of our patient move. They will be giving the families a letter from our chief nursing officer that explains to them that they're an exciting part of LaPorte Hospital and certainly the history, and that they will be relocated on the next day. It asks them to take home any personal effects, so that way you guys are not transporting a bunch of personal items, so they're asked to take home personal effects. It asks them not to come to the facility on move day in the morning, because we want to be sure that we're maintaining our privacy for all of our patients. Now, again, common sense always prevails. If we have a patient who is in the dying process or a patient who is in the process of being born, of course we would expect a family member to be there with them. Since we're not going to have a lot of visitors to the facility, we believe that this will make the process much smoother. Case managers will then notify one family member once the patient has been relocated to destination. The purpose of that notification is just to let them know that they arrived safely, not to at that time invite them into the facility. We do anticipate that the move will conclude 4 hours after we start, but we'll have a better feel for that the week of the patient move. I want you to know that if you arrive at 2 a.m., regardless of whether you walk into origin or destination. Most importantly, there's going to be coffee and beverages. There will also be grab and go snacks all along the path of travel. We want to make sure that you guys are well taken care of because we know that you're taking good care of our patients, and we are very grateful. Thank you so much.